Today's launch of the public information campaign is another major step forward in the government's plan to deal with debt and help people in major financial distress. The three new insolvency arrangements offered through the Insolvency Service will be of substantial assistance to thousands of individuals and thousands of families across the state. The new insolvency arrangements have the capacity to provide certainty for those crippled by unsustainable debt. They provide fair and equitable solutions for those with no prospect of fully repaying their debts. And the guidelines on reasonable expenses provide an essential defensive shield to ensure that neither financial institutions nor other creditors attempt to deprive debtors of funds they truly need for reasonable household and family expenditure, or indeed deprive debtors in employment from benefiting from continuing employment where a debt settlement or personal insolvency arrangement is completed.
Colleagues and I have been motivated by one single objective: to put the best solutions possible in place for people who are living under the burden of debt, for people who are insolvent. We know that such people are living in distress. We know the very difficult decisions that they're having to deal with on a day-to-day basis in terms of what bills they can pay, what they can't, and in terms of ensuring that they have food on the table. We know above all the worry and the anxiety and the distress that the many money challenges such as this can cause, how they can eat up people's lives. For that reason, we have been highly conscious of putting in place as quickly as possible the new debt solutions, bearing in mind the very complex issues that we have to address within the legislation, but also in terms of ensuring that we get the right balance of the rights of creditors, the rights of debtors, moral hazard, and even just the actual backbone or framework required to make these debt solutions possible.
Ultimately, our responsibility will be to help deliver people who are currently insolvent back to solvency in a fair, transparent and equitable manner. And what we are bringing about and facilitating are three new alternatives to bankruptcy for people who currently can't pay their debts. So they no longer need to necessarily go into a costly and time-consuming bankruptcy regime to deal with their difficulties.
So as you know, there are three new debt solutions. The debt relief note, which is relief for those with very little income, very little assets, and potentially can see debt of up to €20,000 written off after a 3-year supervisory period. We also have the debt settlement arrangement, which offers the solution for insolvent debtors where they have unsecured debt, credit union loans, credit card loans, overdrafts, etc. And then we have the personal insolvency arrangement, the PIA, which addresses both secured and unsecured debt.
And today we have launched an information campaign. We have opened a website, www.isi.gov.ie, which will allow stakeholders, not just debtors, but also creditors and others, to allow themselves to get familiar with these new arrangements, which hopefully will be in place by the end of June. There are a number of guides, as I said. There is also a number of sample scenarios for people to see what an actual arrangement might look like, as well as frequently asked questions and links to other websites that will be of assistance to those who currently have debt difficulties. Debtors should familiarise themselves with the options that the new debt solutions offer to them. I would urge them to be mindful that it is always in their best interests to try and continue to work with their creditors and to resolve their difficulties before exploring any of these formal insolvency arrangements. In fact, this type of cooperation is a prerequisite for anyone entering into a personal insolvency arrangement. Those wishing to apply as practitioners should use the intervening period as an opportunity to familiarise themselves with the legislation, begin the necessary work to ensure that they are in a position to apply for authorisation, and liaise with creditors to understand what their expectations around the proposals are. Creditors should also use this time to familiarise themselves with the operational challenges that the new solutions may bring about. And they should also endeavour to deal with as many problem loans as possible, short of any formal insolvency process. I firmly believe that these new debt solutions are not just good for debtors, but also are in the interests of creditors by offering an efficient and a fair means to tackle what is a very large problem for all of the main banks and creditors generally. And the way that you would define somebody as being insolvent typically is that where they aren't able to discharge their debts as they fall due. So if people today don't have enough money to pay the credit card bill on time, to pay the credit union or the mortgage or so on, they in effect, generally speaking, are insolvent. And what these new arrangements offer is a solution or a light at the end of the tunnel to deal with that difficulty, put them back on a sustainable footing and have a second chance.
Our objective in everything we've done in relation to debt resolution mechanisms is to help people who are in genuine financial distress, to facilitate their return to solvency, and to allow individuals and families presently sinking under the weight of unsustainable debt to restart their lives. I come back to a phrase I used earlier. It is legislation being implemented to give people currently burdened by unsustainable debt real and genuine hope of a better future.
And let me close by saying that I believe it is in all of our interests, in the best interests of society and our economy, for the ISI to meet its core objective, which is to restore people who are insolvent to solvency in a fair, equitable, and transparent way. And I can assure everyone here today in the room and listening and watching that the ISI will do everything within its power to begin achieving its objectives by the end of June of this year.